It has everything. Blazing speed, unlimited text and talk. Well, sure, it has apps. What's the use of a smartphone without apps?
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. I shall be late.
Hey, can you shut it down? I'm on the phone. Oh. Thanks. Seriously, take it down a notch.
I'm late.
Hey, are you still there? Great, now my phone's dead. Thanks a lot, Rabbit. Do you know where I can recharge my phone?
Oh, ears and whiskers, I can't believe how light it is.
Is there a cafe close by, somewhere I can plug it in? Lost in the woods, no phone, no GPS. This must be how the pioneers felt. And now, just fabulous. It looks like rain. Oh, what an ugly storm.
Seriously!
Oh. Hold on a sec, I'm talking to you. What's this?
What's it look like?
A rabbit hole.
Wow!
Is it safe?
Safe enough.
I should Google it.
No time!
I seem to be falling. In fact, I'm sure I'm falling. There seems to be no end. Echo! No power and no service. Verizon is the worst.
When all of a sudden, thump!
Thump!
Where am I? Where have I landed?
The Hall of Strange Doors. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you.
Thanks. Hey, dwarves aren't supposed to talk.
And young girls
are supposed to sneeze without covering their yappers.
I must have caught a cold in that ugly storm. I wonder where these doors lead.
Locked.
Locked?
Locked.
Then how am I supposed to get out of here? I wonder what this is for. Maybe this key will open one of you.
Not me.
Nada.
Then I'll just have to break one of you down.
Awful girl.
That would hurt.
How ladylike.
Which one of you shall it be?
He's best.
No, she's best.
I'm much too sturdy.
What about me?
What about you?
It's my secret that the key unlocks.
But you're such a tiny door. What secrets could you have?
Secrets of the other side.
What'll I find there?
A most magnificent garden full of white roses and tiger lilies. It's called Wonderland.
Roses? Or lilies?
Apparently not.
What about white or tiger?
If it were, I'd be dancing now, wouldn't I?
Then the word must be Wonderland.
Only known her for 5 minutes.
Sorry?
You always gush.
So embarrassing.
Forgive them. They haven't been open in centuries.
I guess I'm off then to this place. What is it you call it? Wonderland?
So long, Popsicle. You're out of luck.
See you later, bright eyes.
But wait, the garden where the Queen's croquet match is to take place. I have to find it. It's one of the reasons I've come to Wonderland. Newspapers?
Yep.
Read all about it!
Hot off the presents!
Get your trap trivia!
Get your next trap
queen! Okay!
Prince is so dead. Wait! Which way through the woods?
Ooh, dear, I shall be quick. I shall be late.
Oh! Crazy rabbit!
The queen's to play croquet! She's to play croquet!
I know already! Chill! Aren't you going to help me out? You know, maybe you should take a Xanax. My
mom and her pharmaceuticals. I'm off to play croquet.
Hold on a sec, rabbit. But now, a cat? Cute kitty, kitty. What are you doing out in these woods?
I should ask you the same thing.
Oh, you can speak.
This is news to you.
My cat Dinah. She can't speak.
I'll wager that she can, but chooses not to.
Oh, she tries, but whenever she opens her mouth, all that comes out is...
meow.
Yes!
Oh, this trick in the book. It's not that she doesn't talk, it's that she doesn't talk to you.
That's a very cruel thing to assume.
I assume nothing.
Can you tell me which way I ought to go from here?
That depends a great deal on where you want to get to.
At this point, I don't much care where.
It doesn't matter which way you go.
So long as I get somewhere.
Oh, you're sure to do that if you only walk enough. In that direction lives the Hatter, and in that direction lives the March Hare. Over there is the house of Tweedledum and Tweedledee, and along that way you'll find Humpty Dumpty on his wall. Is it any of like? They're all mad.
But I don't want to go among mad people.
Can't help that. We're all mad here. I'm mad. You're mad.
How do you know I'm mad?
Well, you must be, or you wouldn't have come here.
Can't you be still?
Be still?
You keep coming and going, like bad Wi-Fi. It's very rude.
Did you play croquet with the queen today?
Oh, I'd like to very much, but I wasn't invited.
Have you played before?
Never. I hardly know the game at all.
Well, you don't need an invitation. As long as you have the proper equipment.
A mallet and ball?
A hedgehog and flamingo.
I don't see what those have to do with croquet.
How would you know if you haven't played?
I'm getting a headache talking to you.
Is it my purr?
It's your grin.
I'm of the opinion that more cats should grin. We'd have a much rosier reputation.
I somehow doubt that.
The tea party is underway. I wonder if they've saved me a seat. No matter if they haven't, I can never stay. It's just nice to be thought of. I'll be on my way now, and I'll be taking my grin with me.
No room.
No room!
But there's tons of room.
I see!
This spot will do, don't you think?
Maybe we're waiting for others.
What others?
That's for us to know and you to believe.
But I don't believe you. I think you're lying. I think you don't want me here.
That is true. We don't want you here.
Well, I am here and I'm not leaving. And I'd love some refreshments.
Have some wine.
I don't see any wine.
There isn't any.
Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it.
It wasn't very civil of you to sit down without being invited!
Good one, Zing!
Why don't we all just let it go and try to get along?
Your hair needs cutting.
What?
Your hair. It needs cutting. May I cut it?
Absolutely not!
Are you attached to that position?
Firmly!
Stop it, girl!
It isn't polite to name call.
What would it hurt you to cut your hair?
It cheers him so.
What does he know about haircutting?
He's a hatcher!
It's his job to shave heads.
No!
She won't budge.
What?
Why is a raven like a writing desk?
A riddle? I like riddles. Why?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Nor I!
It's a waste of time to ask riddles without knowing the answer.
Why must everything have an answer?
Excellent question! Though I have a dead answer!
I'll Google it later.
Google it?
Google has all the answers.
Who's this Google person?
It's not a person, it's a search engine.
Well, I don't care for him or his engine!
What day of the month is it?
The 29th.
Ugh, 2 days wrong, yet again.
What a funny watch. It tells the day of the month, but it doesn't tell the hour.
Why should it? Does yours tell the year?
No, but that's because it's the same year for such a long time.
Which is the case with mine.
You've lost me.
The dormouse is asleep again.
You mean to say...
I mean to say precisely what I said.
Which is that the hour here is fixed.
The year comes and goes, but the hour is forever the same.
That's messed up.
If you knew time like we knew time, it would be all clear to you.
But it's not logical.
I dare say, how would you know? You've never even spoken to time.
Too busy hanging out with that Google fella!
Does he treat you well?
Shall I pour tea on her nose?
What's that it's singing?
Twinkle, twinkle.
Ooh, I have you know I once sang that for the Queen of Hearts.
You sang for the Queen?
At the Grand Ball.
It's true, he did. 2 days later, I went mad.
Don't hurt yourself.
Wouldn't now. You have to be sane to recognize madness?
Not so. I'm quite mad and quite aware of it.
Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder what you're at.
You know
up
the
above the world.
Something like it?
Like a tea tray in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little. And I had barely finished the first verse when the Queen bawled out,
"He's murdering time! Off with his head!"
Murdering time? How do you murder time?
She felt my tempo was off.
I felt he was majestic.
And ever since then, time won't do a thing I ask it. It's always 5 o'clock here.
Oh, I get it. It's always tea time.
We've never any time to wash the dishes!
Perpetual tea.
Because you murdered time.
I was framed!
You can't get a fair trial in Wonderland!
Let's change the subject. I'm tired of this talk of time. Let's pretend it doesn't exist for the time being.
I love the young lady talking.
tells us a story.
I don't know one.
Then the Dormouse shall.
I went to sleep. I put out the worm.
Then what have we been talking about?
Bees.
Tell us a story.
About beehives.
About whatever.
And be quick about it, or you'll be asleep before you're done.
Okay, then. Let's see. Once upon a time, the three sisters, and they lived at the bottom of a well.
What were their names?
Let's see. The names are Kelly, Shelly, and... Zim!
Those are the names of my sisters!
It has a flair for realism.
And let's see. They lived at the bottom of a well.
You said that part already. We know their names.
Have I told this story before?
Maybe you should begin again.
Yes, good idea.
I don't...
Then you shouldn't talk. Go on, Mouse.
May I rest my head on the table?
Bravo, bravo!
Bravo, bravo!
The story had me from beginning to end.
Thank you.
But there was no beginning or end. Just gibberish.
Have the courage to applaud what you don't understand!
There was nothing to understand!
Shows what you know.
That mouse is a poet. Genius.
Take some more tea!
I've had nothing yet, so I can't take more.
You mean you can't take less? It's very easy to take more than nothing.
No one asked for your opinion.
Ooh, who's being snippy now?
Keep your tea and your butter and biscuits. I've had enough. The two of you should be ashamed treating a guest in this way. Whatever happened to manners?
They must have died with the time.
I am sick of your riddles and phrases and mind games. The two of you think you're so clever, but you're really just a couple of stuck-up old creeps.
We are what she dreams.
You mean to say?
I mean to say we're her inventions.
So when she wakes?
We die.
That's very sad.
Indeed.
Well, we must make the most of the moments that we have.
And we shall strive to do so.
What time is it?
Tea time.
I must make haste, or I shall be late.
Waxworks, you ought to pay, you know.
Contrarywise, if you think we're a lie, you ought to speak.
Well, I... You were taken by surprise.
You could say.
Unsure what to make of us?
I've never come across anything like the two of you.
You've become wrong!
The first thing in a visit is to say...
How do you do? Okay, then. How do you do?
There.
Now we're afoot.
Tell me the best way out of these woods. It's getting so dark.
Next, we dance.
But the sun's nearly gone.
We dance now.
Isn't it unsafe?
Dancing?
Nonsense.
Just follow our lead.
No, I'm
ring around the rosy pocket.
for you.
It's dangerous to continue.
What we need now is some water.
What we need now is an oxygen tank.
What's that strange noise?
My wheezing.
My panting.
No, no, it's coming from over there. Oh, that's just the king of hearts snoring.
Come, look at him.
Isn't he a lovely sight?
I'm afraid he'll catch a cold sleeping on the damp grass.
He's dreaming now.
About what, I wonder?
You don't know?
No one can guess what someone else is dreaming.
Why? He's dreaming about you, I wager.
How could you possibly know that?
Because you're here. And if he'd left off dreaming about you, where do you suppose you'd be?
I'd still be here, same as now.
You'd be nowhere.
What do you mean?
Why, you're only a sort of thing in his dream.
And if he were to wake, you'd go out.
Bang!
Like a candle.
This is all ridiculous. If I'm only a thing in his dream, what are you, I'd like to know?
Ditto.
Ditto, ditto.
Hush, or he'll wake him.
And then we'd all be kaput.
You know very well you're not real.
I am real.
You want to make yourself a bit realer by crying.
If I wasn't real, I wouldn't be able to cry.
Those aren't real tears. No how.
I've wasted too much time with the two of you. I'd better be getting out of these woods. It's getting so dark. Do you think it'll rain?
No, I don't. Not under here. No how.
Oh, but it may rain outside. We have no objection.
Good night! What's that now?
Oh dear,
what a big black cloud that is! And I do believe it's got wings!
The Jabberwock?
The Jabberwock?
The Jabberwock!
The Jabberwock?
Some people haven't the sense. of a baby.
I said you look like an egg, sir, and some eggs are very pretty, you know.
Stop chattering to yourself and come forth and tell me your name and business.
My name is Alice.
That's a stupid name. What's it mean?
Must a name mean something?
Well, of course it must. My name indicates the shape I'm in, and a fine, handsome shape it is. With a name like yours, you can be shaped like anything.
Why do you sit here all alone?
Because there's nobody up here, stupid girl.
Don't you think you'd be safer down on the ground?
What tremendously easy riddle do you pose? Why, if I were to fall off, of which there is no chance, I have a promise from the king, from the king's own mouth
to send all his horses and his men.
How'd you know that?
It's in a book.
In a book?
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty together again.
That's right. All king's horses, all king's men, they'd be here in a minute to pick me up. Yes, they would.
What a beautiful belt you've got on. Or is it a scarf?
It's very provoking to have somebody not know the difference between a belt and a scarf.
Well, you're such an odd shape. It could be either one.
Well, it's a belt, as you have observed, and a beautiful one. It was given to me by the king and queen.
Was it really?
Yes. We're close. Real tight. They gave it to me. They gave it to me for an unbirthday present.
I beg your pardon?
I'm not offended.
What's an unbirthday present?
An unbirthday present is a present that you get when it is not your birthday.
I like birthday presents the most.
You don't know anything. Nothing. How many days are there in a year?
365.
And how many birthdays have you?
One.
Therefore, there are 364 days where you could possibly get an unbirthday present.
Right.
And only one for birthdays. Glory, I tell ya!
I don't know what you mean by glory.
Of course you don't, because I haven't told you yet. Glory means a knockdown, drag-out argument that I want.
But that's not what glory means.
When I use a word, I choose what it means, neither more nor less.
You decide?
One must master one's words, or one's words will master you. You know, some of them got a temper. Verbs, mostly. Adjectives you can do anything with, but not verbs. No. But I can handle all of them. I know every word, therefore, I know every poem that was ever invented and can explain poems that haven't been invented yet.
It's impossible to know all words.
All words of my friends or at least acquaintances.
I bet I could stump you.
You dare challenge me?
I bet I could find a word online that you don't know.
Online?
Oh. But wait, my phone doesn't work.
Phone?
My smartphone.
Smartphone? What's so smart about it?
If it were charged, I could access the internet.
Internet?
Yeah, you know, the internet.
Oh, I must admit, you have stumped me. Your strange, strange words. You're very crafty. I see you have an army of words of your own.
But I haven't even...
Gosh, please, don't boast. You befuddled me with your words, your strange, strange words. Now goodbye.
Goodbye?
Yes, are we down here?
I was hoping you could point me in the direction.
I cannot.
But I haven't finished.
I cannot and I will not. Pointing is very rude and vulgar.
If you could just tell me where the guard is.
You have stumped me with your strange, strange words. Now it's time for you and your bizarre words to be going. Goodbye.
Okay then, if you say so. Till we meet again.
I do not think I would know you if we did meet again. You're so very much like other people.
You mean my face?
Well, that's the primary complaint. You see, you got your eyes on both sides of your nose in the middle, mouth on the bottom. Now say it.
if you had both eyes on one side and mouth on top, then I'd possibly remember you.
But it looked nice.
That nice? That is not the point! It's not the point! It's not important! You don't understand, you see? Wait a minute. You feel that? Feel that?
Feel what?
Slippage!
Slippage?
Yeah, I'm feeling uncertain. Unloyal. I'm falling. Calling horses. Calling man.
Are you okay?
Pardon me.
Shut up.
You shut up too, Daisy.
I hate it when you all fight over me.
Ladies,
bickering.
Who are you to tell us what to do?
Yeah, who are you?
If you don't hold your tongues, I'll pick you.
You're no flower. You're an animal.
That's true, actually.
I feel sick!
I feel faint!
This is cruel!
Don't worry, I won't pick you. But I do need your help. Who were you describing earlier?
Earlier? I couldn't say. Flowers have very short-term memories.
You said she had 9 points.
That's not ringing any bells.
You were all having a good laugh over her.
Laughing together, us?
That never happens. I think the person you were describing may have been the Queen of Hearts, and I'm desperately trying to find her croquet game.
Is that the queen there?
I'll hear no more of it!
Listen to reason, dumpling.
The croquet will go on.
But there's rain coming. Look at that storm cloud there.
Oh, what a little rain.
Everyone knows you can't play croquet in the rain.
Rain? Did he say rain?
I think he did.
This is wretched. Just wretched.
Well, there'll be other days for croquet.
I was partial to this one.
Oh, we could play chess instead.
I'd rather watch a beheading.
Well, there's not one scheduled for today. You cleared your slate to play croquet.
Then we must schedule one immediately.
For what offense?
Someone must pay for the rain!
Chester.
I don't mean to interrupt, but are you perhaps the Queen of Hearts?
No, I'm the milkman. What does it look like, child?
My name is Alice, if it pleases your majesty.
It does not.
Just the same, it's a great honor to meet you.
Curtsy when you address me, girl. This isn't the rodeo.
Rodeo?
Curtsy!
Yes, of course. Your majesty, it is most awesome to be in your presence.
Awesome.
Really awesome.
What a queer tongue she has, what'd she say?
Borderline gibberish.
I should like to tear it out. Where do you come from? Where are you going? Look up, speak nicely, and don't twiddle your fingers.
Oh, she hates finger twiddling.
Where I've been and where I'm going, it's not easy to say.
Try.
Well, I came to a rabbit hole, you see, and then I found some talking doors. I went through one of them and I lost my way.
Your way? I don't quite know what you mean by your way. All the ways here belong to me.
Yes, of course. I should have known.
There is much you should know.
Oh, nicely put, Dumpling.
Don't call me Dumpling in public.
Sorry.
Sure.
As you wish.
Where was I?
Wherever you went.
Before this noodle of a girl interrupted me.
Noodle?
I couldn't say.
What was I on about? It was something important.
Yes, as I recall, it had something to do with dessert recipes.
No, no, it was the rain. I was demanding that someone must pay for the rain.
Yes, yes, I remember now. We have to take shelter.
Her! She's to blame for the rain! And the end of my croquette! And my croquette!
Croquet! It's pronounced croquet!
She must be punished!
Oh, really, did you think about this?
Guards! Where are my guards? Either will do. Off with her head, I say.
You can't behead someone over a little rain.
I can and I will.
Oh, she rules by extreme measures.
I only wanted to see the garden!
And was it to your liking?
It's not worth dying over!
We all lose our heads sometimes.
King, please, you have to help me.
Really, dear, perhaps the girl's right. A little rain is no reason to behead someone.
I want her head to roll!
crime will be fitting the punishment.
Not rain.
No, not rain.
But instead.
Instead of crime, but the chopping off of one's head isn't so...
So...
So extreme.
I see. Like theft.
A theft? Now you're thinking!
Is this how they always talk?
Yeah! Can you think of a theft? A recent theft? So terrible. So ghastly! That it might justify the loss of one's head.
I just remembered. Someone this very morning stole my tots.
The horror!
Yes. I'm quite certain this very morning my tarts were ransacked.
Your tarts were ransacked and you're only now telling me.
I've only now thought of it. I mean, remembered it.
You just made it up.
Well,
do you?
Hey!
Got it!
Accuse the lady.
This tart thief must be brought to justice!
Post-haste!
Whom do you suspect?
It could only have been one person.
Whom, my love, whom?
The Maid of Hearts.
Maid of Hearts? Well, we couldn't be had one of our own maids! How is it so hard to find these days?
The Maid of Hearts is standing here before us.
You mean?
Alex!
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 No! That makes no sense! I've never met you till now!
Yes, Alex! The Maid of Hearts stole my cards!
Of course! It's all fitting together!
Nothing's fitting together! You're all crazy!
Off with her head!
I demand a trial!
It's a waste of time!
But you've proven nothing yet!
Very well! That will be a trial immediately! I command it! And everyone must attend to see this fiend brought to justice! Everyone, I say! Everyone that calls their home Wonderland!
The Maid of Hearts. She stole those tarts and took them quite away.
What the? Is the jury surveyed?
We haven't even had the trial yet.
Oh, yes. The first witness.
The court calls a strange door. State your name for the court. I'm a door. And did you ever meet this Alice?
In the Hall of Strange Doors.
And what were you doing there?
I'm a strange door.
Oh, right. Can you describe your relationship with this Alice?
Cordial, I suppose.
You like this Alice?
Well, what I know of her, except there was this one thing.
Yes?
It's too monstrous to mention.
Oh, take your time.
I've never been so afraid in my life.
But please, we must know. The court must know.
It's unspeakable.
Oh, speak it, I beg of you. What is this heinous thing that Alice did?
Well, me and my friends, she threatened to break us down.
She threatened to pay us for our sins!
Oh,
excused.
Must we continue? Judging from the door, it seems open and shut.
Can there be any doubt? A character of disrepute, the deviousness, the arrogance.
She tried to take away my joy of smoking.
Pardon me, your majesties, for bringing this in. I hadn't finished tea when I was called.
Take off your hat.
Ooh. Not mine.
Stolen?
No. I keep them to sell. I have none of my own. I'm a hatter.
Is that so?
Yes, and a fine one as well.
Have you ever met this girl?
Yes, I have.
And when was that?
At tea time.
You invited her for tea?
Why would I do that? No.
Well, then how did the two of you know? How did the two of you become acquainted?
She forced her company on us.
Ew! That's appalling.
She sat herself down at our table without entreating, mind you, and gobbled up all the crumpets.
She did. I was there. Every crumpet in sight! You see, if she'd gobble up crumpets, she'd surely steal talk.
Here.
Why are you telling such lies?
That's not the worst of it.
There's more?
She mocked the Dormouse's story. She pestered it with questions concerning plotline until it was nearly humiliated.
Its story was nonsense.
The Dormouse's story was an examination of life and death and everything in between.
Don't you agree?
I vehemently object.
You agree?
I vehemently agree.
You see?
Said,
call the next witness!
But I haven't finished questioning this one yet.
He's drinking tea. Time to move on.
The court calls Tweedledum and Tweedledee.
State your names for the court.
I'm Dee.
I'm Dumb.
Indeed.
Have you ever met this girl?
She accosted us in the woods.
She accosted you?
In the woods, she did.
How did she accost you?
She forced us to dance.
And in doing so, nearly ended us. Now, why would we do that?
Physical activity is not our strong suit.
No how.
Well, what happened after she accosted you in the woods and forced you to dance and you nearly died?
You don't want to know.
You really don't.
Why is that?
You'll never sleep soundly again.
No how.
What happened?
A dark cloud came over us.
Black and thick.
A rain cloud?
The Jabberwock!
The Jabberwock!
The Jabberwock!
You see? A thief? A murderer? Everywhere she goes, the Jabberwock follows!
Guilty! Guilty! Guilty in all kinds of stealing cards from the Queen of Hearts!
Off with her head!
Off with her head!
Stay away!
Yeah, come on.